How does it work for me as a tourist?
The first thing you do is you go to Travel Buddy, yes, my website, and you go and register, and the registration is there. You click on register.
You can already do that back home.
Anywhere in the world.
Before leaving.
Before leaving. And you click on there, and then you register. And then we will know in advance what day you're arriving. And once you get to South Africa, you get a SIM card, local SIM card, and you put it in a spare phone, if you have one. It's not necessary, but it's always better.
Yeah.
So that we can track wherever you are in South Africa, and your family back home can also click on a little link, and your mother and father or your brother or sister, whoever, can actually watch you on Google Earth where you're traveling, where you've
really?
Been. Yeah, it's fantastic.
And you can just have any regular South African phone card?
That's it. You do that, but when you get to South Africa, you've got to set it up, but it's all the instructions on here. And then once a day, I think it's 6 o'clock in the morning and 6 o'clock in the evening, we'll actually locate your position, and we'll put it on Google Earth. So your family back home, you can put it on Facebook, and they can actually see where you're traveling. So if you were meant to be in Cape Town today and you're still sitting far up there, the people say, oh, get worried, what's happening? They'll phone you and say, what's your problem?
Yeah.
Not us, your friends. We don't have anything to do with you. We don't send you SMSs. We don't spam you. We don't have anything to do with you. The only thing that we have to do with you is when you get to South Africa and you have a problem, then we give you this number, and it's a Travel Buddy number. And when you dial this number, it comes through to this is what you're hearing.
So after I've registered, then what?
We'll give you a number that you can contact if you're in trouble.
You put that in your phone and that's enough?
That's it.
And then, I call that number, what happens?
You get through to one of our hubs, and our hubs will then generate a viral message through to all of our members, and whichever member is available in that area will come and assist you. You know, you might have one member that's not looking at his phone, you might have another member that's in a meeting, but we've got quite a few, we've got 70,000 members, and one of them will contact you. But we will target that. Don't worry about that. We'll look after you.
And then that person can help you and assist you in what kind of things?
Well, we will harness the collective clout of that community. It will be like you at home. When you're at home, you've got a network of people where you know where to go. All our members have got their own little private network. So when you contact them, you need a doctor, you need a dentist, you need to go and do something, or you lost your passport, or whatever your problem is, you just think that you're talking to a friend at home who's got all of those contacts available. They open up their own little black book, they see how they can help you. Now you can imagine the power of that. We harness that collective clout of that community. So we utilize these people's personalized stuff, but we put it together. And it's a lot of fun, and it's a lot of positive energy that is put into tourism. And our members are ordinary volunteer South Africans who are out there with their own little security networks or self-help networks or their own little black book. So whatever your problem is, it's like having a friend in South Africa who can just help you.
What kind of problems can you assist with or can they assist with?
Anything from a child who's got a sore throat, or you're losing your passport, or you're completely lost and you don't know what to do and you need some friendly South African advice, to crime, to whatever it is. We live here, we know where the post office is, where the policeman is, where the doctor is, where the ambulance is, and we've got all of those things for ourselves. We're going to just introduce you and say, there's my network, how can I help you?
And isn't it better if you get robbed, for instance, and immediately call the police, you know?
Well, you know, the police can't be everywhere. And the police have got serious things to handle, and maybe you don't know how to get hold of the police, because wherever you are in South Africa, you might think, well, this is the number. Maybe it changes. There is one central number. But we are going to utilize our collective group in South Africa, and they will then call the police, and they will do those things for you. So it's like having somebody there who's like a guardian angel to sort you out.
Why do people become volunteers?
Because we're just a hell of a lot of nice people in South Africa. We like to, you know, in South Africa we've been through a bit of a growth stage, and we've been through a lot of trauma, but there's a very positive mood in South Africa at the moment, and the South Africans actually are gelling together to make things work. And we've been trying this, and it's been evolving over 10 years or 15 years, and we're actually at a stage now which is very exciting, where everybody wants to help, because they're calling over each other to help each other, to find the rhino poachers, to find criminals, to help tourists. We're just a whole bunch of South Africans that are collectively very positive.